imagining anyone not
on board. Says you're reliable. When they talk about being against the war, Vito said you'd be expecting me.
Took you long enough. I'm Jock Blanchard. Vito claims you can unfug this mess and get us working men back on a job.
Maybe. Depends if your information's any good.
Used to kick up to Vito's men, Andy Toretto, for union work. But now that Cleon Greco got Andy squeezing everybody for more dues. You don't pay, you don't get a work permit. Poor fucks even gotta use Greco's loudmouth buddies to collect.
This Greco sounds like a real piece of shit.
You don't know the half of it. On top of that, Andy's gotta keep the permits under lock and key. Anything happens to those, oof, ain't no work happening around here.
I'll see what I can get out of Toretto's people.
Toretto runs a tight ship, but you should be able to get some of his guys talking.
Thank you.
ass lie, dipshit.
Hey! Hey! Over here! You ain't that sly, dipshit.
No respect for us. Oh, Lord! I'm calling the police!
Ah!
all units. Pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrol. Repeat, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrol.
Anytime they need one. Plus, they come in that convenient flip-top box that's as rugged and...
Thank you.
slowing work at the dock union. I'm surprised. Word is Andy Toretto's down at the dock union, demanding to know who's been stopping his people from collecting dues.
Think he tipped off Greco to what's been happening?
Nah. Knowing Andy, he'd probably see Greco in the ground next to you if he could. But he's a lifer, and if he's got a job to do, he's gonna goddamn well do it. Bad fucking situation all around.
And it's about to get worse. Tell the boys they'll be back to work soon, Jock.
You pissed Toretto off just enough that he's back at the dock union. You're gonna have to deal with him.
Vito says you can help me get this bread of mine to a safe place.
Sure can, honey. And a friend of Vito's is a friend of mine. Be there lickety-split.
Your money's always safer with me, Shay.
Get this out of here!
Okay, I'm good to go.
Apart. I want his ass now! Get him from the other side!
He's all yours, boys!
There he goes!
I see him! There he is!
He's all yours, boys!
They wanted you to hurt me! Take a cover!
Yeah!
I got you.
Kill one of our boys.
Run for cover.
He's all yours, boys.
Kill me, or that pissant Greco does.
Well, since Greco ain't here. The dock union's under control. Put some of you guys on it.
Watch. Get the warehouse, and we get Greco. Easy as your mama's fucking pie.
Today, I'm sure the file on Vito's skelet is about 3 feet thick, but that wasn't always the case. Hoover didn't even acknowledge the Mafia existed until 1957, so we weren't really keeping tabs on guys like Vittorio Scaletta till after that. Now, we know he served in World War II and did a 6-year stint in prison for theft and illegal distribution of federal rations. It's generally believed he was a made member of the Falcone family in Empire Bay, though he's also a suspect in the death of Don Carlo Falcone. Now, if he did kill the Don, Vito must have had friends in high places because he was allowed to live. He was exiled, though, and forced to relocate down here, and the commission convinced Sal Marcano to make Vito a lieutenant and give him some rackets.
Shop's whites only, boy. You pushing your luck, boy.
Christ! I'm calling the cops!
Ah.
Vito sent me. You're Connie, right?
Yup. Connie DeMarco. Been keeping an eye on the smuggling business for Vito. Roy Thibodeau's in charge now, and it's a damn shit show.
Why hasn't Greco bounced him yet?
Oh, he bounced Roy right into a hole if he got to say so. Greco didn't pick Roy, and that puts a target on his back. Still, Roy's trying to sell the usual shit from out of Cuba. Cigars and rum, mostly. Hell, rumor has it they even selling medicine and shit to the Cubans.
Sounds like Greco scrambling.
Imagine Greco thought his Uncle Sal'd give him a break, but no. So he's squeezing everyone, including Roy. Business gets any worse, Roy's gonna have to come down and see to it himself. Mind, Roy's got a few guys here and there.
Might take some persuading, but I'll get him to talk.
You get hold of any Roy's guys yet? They're sure to talk if you, ask just right.
Thank you.
to us.
Just get to the phone.
Stupid son bitch.
Feeling a little alive, fellas. I'd have to fold after this one.
Breaking news in New Bordeaux. Hollis Dupree, the white resident of Southdowns who allegedly killed two colored men in self-defense in front of his home, has been arrested. According to Dupree's defense attorney. Pressure from local civil rights leaders and growing national attention on the case is what motivated the DA to file charges. The Korean War veteran has been released on bail pending trial. Dupree is accused of killing Vietnam veterans Trey McCall and Ahmaud Harris after the young men knocked on his front door seeking help with a flat tire.
Anybody follow you? Roy is rattled, scared of Greco, terrified of you. Heard he started sleeping at the warehouse, the only place he feels safe.
Good. Means I have an easier time getting my hands on him.
Once he's taken care of, we'll move in. Vito will turn things around. You'll see. That poor fucker Roy is back at the warehouse. Do what you gotta do.
Assuming a man hitting us don't sneak in here and cut your goddamn throat. Maybe you should worry about that.
Cover fire, River Road!
Of course. Be there soon.
There's a boy who was just here.
He was around here somewhere.
He's murdering.
Oh, shit, that was a good one.
Sandra told me to reach out. I certainly appreciate some help with the phone.
Yeah, you see it?
Yeah, she gave me a heads up. Whatever you need, consider it done. I just appreciate the chance to help.
You don't want to do this!
They'd have killed your ass anyway.
Been a pleasure.
Need you guys to secure the smuggling operation at the warehouse.
Send out some of his men, have them try and take you out. So watch your ass. Get your hands on Greco and rough him up all you want, but don't kill him. That's for me.
How did Lincoln Clay convince Thomas Burke, Vito Scaletta, and the woman known as Cassandra to work together?
He called a sit-down. He told them to meet him at an old plantation house in the bayou. When he had them all in the same room, he laid out how they were going to take down Marcano. Lincoln could be very persuasive.